All right, I'm here with Suda51 doing an interview in relation to Killer is Dead, which is being released worldwide very soon. I'd like to begin with a few questions here. First of all, you've always worked on such unique titles with Killer 7, No More Heroes, and then some of the other recent things, such as Shadows of the Damned. What draws you to these unique style of games?
いつも特徴があって、まあ、キラセブンだったりノーマーヒーローだったりダブルだったり、まあ、今回もゲームなんですけれども、あのなぜいつも特徴のあるゲームを作られるゲームですか？
まず一つにですね、まあ、僕の作品という もちろん意識もあるんですが、当然ながらグラスホッパーというスタジオが作ったっていう何かやっぱそういう存在証明みたいなものを、それはすごく意識して、まあ、当然ながらアートスタイルもそうなんですけども、やっぱり他のスタジオじゃ作れないようなゲームを作ることが僕らの使命だというふうに思ってますね。
So, not just as my own game, but as Grasshopper Manufacturer as a whole, as a studio, I always wanted to create something that's really distinctive for as our game. So that's something that we were always conscious of, and you know, create something that no other studio would be able to make. It's something that we want to do.
You've been working on a number of games over these past years, but I'm always fascinated by the return to the action genre, the hack and slash type of game. What draws you to the genre?
まあ、僕自身のルーツとしてやっぱアクションゲームがすごく好きだったんですね。でアドベンチャーゲームも好きで、おそらく、まあ、自分の感覚なんですけども、まあ、小さい頃若い頃に遊んだゲームアクションゲームなんですけども、だけどもその中には世界があってストーリーがあってキャラクターの物語があって、そのプレイヤーが最後どこに行くのかどこに到達するのか、そういった物語というものを語れる、それがアドベンチャーでありアクションだったんですね。だからこそおそらく僕自身やっぱ脚本を書いて本を書いてゲームを作るので、それに適したスタイルが自分にとってアクションでありアドベンチャーだと思います。はい。
I think I've always loved actions, and I always loved playing action games as well as adventure games. So when you play, I think it's really the best genre to convey the world and then the story and the background story of all the characters in the game, and you know, like let players wonder where this is going in the end. I think it's really a great form of storytelling. So and as I write, I create games, so I write scenarios to create games, and I think that's why I always choose action.
Okay, Tsugi, could you talk about the influence specific to Killer is Dead? For instance, the music, the visual style. What other sort of media perhaps has drawn you back to this sort of design?
うん、僕自身やっぱ雑食なのでいろんな影響を受けてるんですけども、まあ、どれか一つナンバーワンを挙げるとすれば日本の時代劇のテレビシリーズで必殺シリーズっていうのがあるんですね。知ってます？ああ、グレイトグレイト。主人公が中村モンド、同じモンドの名前なんです。で昼は役人 で夜になると暗殺集団のリーダーになるんですね。要は表と裏、光と影がすごくはっきりしてるキャラクターで、僕はこのシリーズが大好きで、その必殺シリーズのインスパイアがすごく大きいですね、今回は。
I really like everything or every forms of entertainment. So it's so a lot of influences comes from different things. spot, if I were to pick number one, then it is a TV series called Hisatsu series. And the main character is called Nakamura Mondo. And he's a public servant during the day. But during the nighttime, he's the leader of these killers. And, you know, he goes on and killing people or executing people. So the contrast between day and night is really sharp, and I really wanted to, you know, get that or reflect that in our game as well. And I guess that's really the number one influence.
Excellent. One more question, I think. I've wondered often about your experiences working with external developers. Killer is Dead, I believe, is an internal Japanese project, but some of the other recent games you've worked on, such as those by Digital Reality, how have your experiences been with that?
あまり毎回コラボレーションを意識しているわけではなくて、まあ、その作品を作るプロジェクトがうまくいくため、その方法論としての一つの形なのかなと思いますね。なので、必ずコラボレーションしたいからということではなくて、一番このゲームにとって最適な形、まあ、それがいろんな選択肢の中からコラボレーションという形になったんじゃないかなと思います。はい。
So it's not like I always want to collaborate with people, but it really depends on the project. I mean, if the project will be successful, or if we see that project will be successful by collaborating, then yeah, we choose it. I mean, we definitely want to choose the best, you know, possible way to create a game. And if the collaboration seems to be the reasonable, you know, or the best option, then we choose it.
Thank you very much. I appreciate your time and look forward to playing.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. ありがとう。